Well, all right, I want to welcome you again to my channel. I'm the guy that obviously does the yellow post. I love the color yellow, and I mean to defend the fact today that John is the disciple that Jesus loved, and also demonstrate that John is the author of the Gospel of John. I can do the very same thing with all the other gospel writers by using the very same men. I love meme theology simply because I meme to defend everything with this yellow post. You can see it. Everything's there. Makes a great presentation. All the information has been researched. It's all cited and sourced, and I have an original source at the bottom. I love the ministry answering islam.org. Top-notch evidence, beyond a shadow of a doubt. I'm a retired Baptist preacher. The kind of theology I have is the kind you'll find at Dallas Theological Seminary. I absolutely love men like Dr. Gary Habermas. I love the work of Dr. Michael Icona. And I try to find as many sources that I can that are supported by atheists. Because once you have an atheist admitting Jesus existed, it's finished, man. You've got a good, good piece of evidence. So I try to do a lot of that. I debate a lot of atheists. I enjoy it. You can call me anytime you want. We've got a gospel, which means the good news of John. It's a written gospel by John. How do we know? The internal evidence, the external evidence. In John chapter 1:14, it says, "And we have seen his glory." We obviously includes the gospel writer. It must then be asked, who is we? The answer is obvious. It's the guy who's writing that gospel. So who has really seen his glory? You could think of Mount Transfiguration, and who was there? Peter, James, and John. All right, now we have in chapter 19:35, he's an eyewitness to the crucifixion when he says, "He who saw it has borne a witness. His testimony is true, and he knows that he is telling the truth, that you may also believe. He is the beloved disciple." Watch 21:20 in John 21:20. The beloved disciple, who we are told is an eyewitness of Christ and the author of the Gospel of John. Because in John 21, after the resurrection appearance, we read in verse 20, Peter turned, watch now, and saw the disciple whom Jesus loved following them. He was the one who had been reclining at the table close to him. Well, 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 well. We have two men in history that were converts and discipled by John personally. It's Papias, and we have Polycarp. Polycarp had a disciple named Irenaeus. Irenaeus gives testimony to what Polycarp says, what Polycarp taught him. He heard him speak. See my other videos. He was acquainted with Polycarp. Polycarp is the pastor in the Church of Smyrna, mentioned in the book of Revelation. Irenaeus is a pupil, a disciple of Polycarp. Went to France. He pastored a church in France. And we have five volumes. It's an encyclopedia called Against Heresies. And watch what Irenaeus says. John, the disciple of the Lord, who also leaned upon his breast, did himself publish a gospel during his residence at Ephesus in Asia. He goes on to say that John appointed him that office, my friend, that office, and appointed other men that took over the apostles' churches. But he makes it very clear, John's the one that leaned upon the Lord's breast. Any Da Vinci painting of the Lord's Supper, you see an apostle leaning on Jesus's breast, and it's John. How do we know? Irenaeus knows Polycarp personally, and Polycarp was converted to Christianity by John. In verse 20 of chapter 21, he's called the beloved disciple. We are told that this is an eyewitness. He says, Peter turned and saw the disciple whom Jesus loved. And what does it say? The one who had been reclining at the table close to him. When men come here as atheists or even religious Christians declaring that it was Lazarus because the Gospels say Jesus loved Lazarus, it's not evidence at all. The best evidence we have that it's John comes right out of the mouth of a man who was saved to Christianity by the Apostle John. His name was Polycarp. Donald Guthrie, one of the greatest scholars of the New Testament, says, "There can be no doubt, therefore, that Irenaeus accepted John, the Apostle, as the author of that gospel, and believed it to have been published at Ephesus on the basis of Polycarp's testimony." Irenaeus is the second century historian. These men could very well have known each other. There's no reason why we can't believe that Justin Martyr did not know Irenaeus. There's no reason to believe, and he made it very clear, he believed it was John that wrote that gospel. Tatian the Assyrian put together the four gospels together, and for the first time in history, in about 140 AD, the gospel appear as one volume. It's called Tatian, the convert and disciple of Justin Martyr, and he labeled it the Diatessaron, meaning through the four gospels. Tertullian, pastoring one of the largest churches in North Africa at Carthage, had a ministry that started in the second century and makes it very clear that the apostle is most certainly the writer of that gospel. Now, we can see clear evidence that John is the one that was leaning on the Lord's breast. And this is confirmed by the Bible, and it's confirmed outside the Bible. The apostle that Jesus loved can be none other than the apostle John. We have mountains of evidence. Mountains. Start with the Muratorian fragment, a piece of paper, a parchment that dates to about 170 AD. Scholars will tell you that it dates about 170 AD. Even the copy that they found dates to about 170 AD. There's no getting out of that. The early part is lost, like the first two books. But virtually all scholars agree it refers to Matthew and Mark, because the other part is what? Luke and John. You just can't get away from that. It's called the Muratorian canon, and what's fascinating about this is it attributes the Gospel of John to the author, which is John, and what's even more beautiful is that about 170 AD, we already had 22 of the books of the New Testament that make up the New Testament. It was one of the very first compilation of New Testament books. It appears for the first time in 170 AD. 27 books to the New Testament. I mean, we have strong evidence in history that's corroborated by the very men that knew the apostles personally. They're called the memoirs of Jesus. They're called the oracles of Jesus. They're called the gospels of Jesus. All these men refer to the four Gospels by different names, different titles, but it's all about the biography of our Savior. Jesus had converts, Paul, Peter, and John. John had a convert, Polycarp, Papias, and Polycarp had a convert, Irenaeus. Irenaeus had a convert, Hippolytus. These men knew each other, Justin Martyr, Tatian, Clement of Alexandria. Clement of Rome, first century, says Paul and Peter established the church in Rome, and who can forget Ignatius of Antioch? This is called the traditional view. It's supported by men like F.F. Bruce, all the scholars that are coming out of Dallas Theological Seminary, Professor Bach, all those guys. It's the historical unbroken chain of evidence. Hey, I want to see you again. Let's talk about the Gospels. Let's talk about the Bible. And let's get informed when we want to correct or at least have good arguments, good answers to the questions that atheists ask our children. Hey, hope to see you again.